This podcast encourages and empowers you to create your own unique real story, develop your own unique real statement, and discover your own unique real self. The power is yours. Good night, Troy Lee. How are you doing on this wonderful, beautiful night?
I'm doing good. The weather was kind to us today, so I'm just happy. I know it's supposed to go and drop back down to the 20s, but I'm happy.
What parts of the world are you in right now?
I am in the great state of North Carolina, Raleigh to be exact. I've been here for the last 5 years. I love it.
Yeah. I loved it too. Would you believe that technically North Carolina was really the startup state of my entire tour?
I think Khalif might have mentioned that to me, and I wish I would have known. I would have tried to jump on last year and hopefully take you out and show you how to get some good food. And yeah.
Oh, that would have been good. Well, it started, my trip did start with my wife in Florida, but the previous year I ventured across there on invitation by Stephen Scoggins. He has something called Transform You, and I came across there, and while there, I put up on, before I left Trinidad and Tobago, I put up something and I said, who's in North Carolina, right? Or who's in Raleigh, North Carolina? And I probably met over a dozen people in the 3 nights that I was there, and that really kind of spiraled the thought of, what would it be like if you visited every state? So yeah, in that perspective, North Carolina was like the birth state of that idea.
Which I could see why. It's a birth state of a lot of ideas, I will say. But we'll definitely get into those and some of my answers.
Yeah, well, let's do that. Let's get in then. So which of your talents is responsible for us connecting at this time?
I think in this particular situation, it would be my podcast talent, my ability to speak on sports and other news. Myself and Kylie Clark, who you did interview last year, we've done Debate Amongst Friends for the last 3 years, which I think ultimately started with a Facebook post. So kind of similar to your story, how it kind of starts with one thing and then it goes to something different. We actually posted a picture up, I think, of how the media portrayed two different individuals who kind of did the exact same thing. And then we noticed that we collectively every day we talked about sports. You know, we debated on sports. We discussed. We went back and forth. And then one day we just said, well, let's do a podcast. And let's not only do a podcast, but, let's help other people do podcasts too if they need help. And that's kind of what we've been doing.
So who did you learn that skill from? Not just the initiative from the perspective of, hey, let's look at it and let's do it, but from the perspective again of you being the person who then helps others achieve it as well. Where did you learn that from?
I think being a coach, I've been a football coach in the past. I think over the last 10 years, I've done a lot of different things. I consider myself to be a renaissance man, a jack of all trades kind of person. So I think being a football coach in the past and just being a positive person, making people realize that no matter where you're from or who you are, everybody has a gift. And I know some people might not want to hear this because of the timing, but I know Bill Belichick of the New England Patriots says it best where he says to do your job, and I think if you do your job, whatever that is, meaning use your talent, you'll be successful. And if you want to do a podcast, don't do it how other people do it. Do it how you would do it. And that's kind of how we help people in a nutshell kind of move forward.
And it's so important. Like, I totally agree with that. I remember doing my first podcast and I was attempting to do it just the exact way Dave Ramsey did his podcast, which is his radio station that he shoots out as a podcast. And you should have heard me. Like, you should. I was like, this is the Jonesy Money Show where debt is dumb. And it was super cool, but I think the litmus test for it is does it register with you? It lives in a place, doesn't it? Like, is this me? Have you seen that?
Absolutely, I agree. And I've listened to his show many a times, and you know, I hear people call in, and you're always wondering, like, you know, it kind of helps you as a listener because you realize that you're not the only person that's going through what those people are going through.
Yeah.
But it's all, everything is different, and I love how everybody has their own style. And that's the part that makes it fun.
So where can we find out more about what you guys do?
Debate Amongst Friends is on YouTube. We're actually moving towards pre-recorded now, but we do go live sometimes, 8:30 on YouTube. You can find us on Facebook, on Instagram, on Twitter, all under Debate Amongst Friends. If you use Google Play, iTunes, it can all be downloaded, all of our latest episodes and all of our content. We typically also play local artists, underground artists on our shows at the end. So if that's something that someone's interested in, we would be more than happy to listen to that track. And we try to promote that on our show as well. And that's just another avenue. And the shows that we work with, we try to instill that in them as well.
Love it. Helping others pursue excellent. Love it. Well, do tell me one other thing that you've done consistently over the last 3 years, please, Troy.
Over the last 3 years, outside of doing podcasts, that is a good question. I think that's the only consistent thing I've done. Well, I'll take that back. I have been a cameraman at my church, I would say, for the last 2 to 3 years. And that's another skill that I have picked up. We have a big media team, 5 cameras. We actually host a live stream for Watts Chapel Baptist Missionary Church here in Raleigh. So I'm one of the cameramen, one of four, I should say. And I would say it's a pretty rewarding experience. Gives me an opportunity to, again, learn a new skill and capture moments for individuals who are watching the service online. Mm-hmm. And, you know, when you're in it, you know, you're trying to listen to the messages of the pastor, but you're also trying to capture those moments of the choir, the moments of the prayer, so that the individuals at home, they can experience it and they can feel it almost as if they're in the pews sitting next to us.
Looking back from then to now, how does it make you feel to see the way your skill has increased and how you have increased by serving in this way?
Well, the skill has definitely increased tremendously, and we've actually taken that skill and kind of multiplied it and kind of done some different things with that particular skill. Now, at the church, I actually went on to become a technical director. So at this particular point, there are some Sundays where I do call the shots. it's a bit nerve-wracking, I will say, but you can kind of see how a small production team, you know, when you're watching TV and you see the camera switching, you're like, hey, I do that. You know, if you're watching a sporting event, you see them switching cameras and switching angles. Hey, you pan here, you fade here, and you see them doing that. You're sitting there like, hey, technically speaking, I call those shots. And it makes you proud inside. But something else I'll probably get into later here, of course, as I said, Raleigh, the birthplace of many things. We actually filmed a movie here, a short movie, that should be coming out shortly this year called, Just a Little Sweeter. And we actually got a chance to play around with some camera work, really use all the skills. And I think that goes back to what I said. If you do your job, you know, you'll be successful. And by do your job, I mean use your skills that God's given you.
Love it. Love it. Hey, I love how you're answering my questions before I even ask them. And you're just knitting it into the storyline. I love it. Love it.
Absolutely.
It's like my legs are crossed right now and my hands are behind my head and I'm all relaxed.
I do podcasts.
Yeah. Yeah. Love it. All right, my friend. Well, let's switch gears for a moment now. Let me invite you into my time machine that is surrounded with beautiful, warm, blue Caribbean water. Troy, what is your earliest childhood memory?
The first thing that came to mind when you said that, I remember I must have been about 4 or 5. I was at a... Well, two memories come to mind, actually. I would think I was at a place called Baby World in Jersey City, where I'm from. And I remember it was my first time learning how to swim. And, you know, I don't know if you have those swimming lessons as a kid, but there's always this one kid that's afraid to jump in. Hmm. Well, I was that kid. I did not want to jump in. I was like, I can kind of like walk in, where are the stairs kind of thing. But, you know, this is my first time. So I was terrified to jump in. And I remember the teacher, she said, oh, I'm going to catch you. And then I jumped in, of course, and she moved. She didn't catch me at all. But I didn't die or anything. But, you know, it was kind of one of those memories. It definitely stuck with me. I'm not afraid of the pool, but I definitely remember that betrayal.
How do you see it connecting to who you are today?
I think ultimately it doesn't have too much effect. I mean, I do keep my circle pretty small. So it could have a, you know, I could have set some boundaries after I was betrayed at such a young age. But I'm sure it probably does have some other, you know, effects to it. But, you know, I just remember that very vividly. I jumped in and she said she would catch me and she didn't. But, you know, I think I've gotten over it.
Hmm. Yeah, it's really cool. My my son is learning to swim now. Well, my sons are learning to swim. So one is 9 at the time of this recording and the other is almost 5. And one of the coaches told him while training him that the other coach, she actually said, you know, he have no fear. He has some rough edges, right? Because he's the guy he's the stern guy, right? He's been he's represented the country and it seems as though he's that guy. And, you know, it's really intriguing how we are impacted, one, by challenges.
Absolutely.
And to see that you experience that and know that you are a coach, it feels as though that isn't one of the ways that you teach. I'm not sure, you can correct me, but I think you're a bit more, I think you're the coach that would actually catch them the first time at least, and possibly not do it the second time if you needed to, if that was required to get them stronger. Is that accurate?
I think that's accurate, and that's actually pretty funny because again, 10 years, I've done a lot of stuff. I'm actually on the advisory board at my company, and, you know, I did have to send out some tough correspondence to someone, you know, just kind of going over some feedback, you know, and some potential things that we might have caught in a session or in a meeting. And just you do want to nip it in the bud and just make sure that it's the type of thing that kind of doesn't arrive or arise later on. But on the football field, that's absolutely correct. And I think you're always teaching technique, you know, and fundamentals. So I think the one thing you do want to do is try to catch it early. You know, if somebody's feet is wrong, you want to show them not only why it's important to have your feet correct, but also the impact, not on the form or not on the play, but sometimes on your own body. Mm. You know, if your feet are wrong or if your posture is wrong, you know, you might get up and you might hurt your back, you know, or you might hurt your leg, or, you know, it's just certain things that might happen if you don't correct those things early. I think you try to watch out and see if they self-correct, but if you don't see that immediately, you have to step in and make sure that they're doing it properly.
Yeah, love that. Ooh. It's philosophically correct. I love that. Yeah, definitely. All right, my friend. Well, if we fast forward to when you were 12, what was your favorite song?
And this is going to sound funny, and I'm sure when people hear this, they're going to be like, what in the world? But when I was 12, I really loved Barry White,
right.
Practice What practice what you preach.
Oh, there we go.
And the only reason I loved it was because my mom, I rode with my mom a lot, and she only had two CDs in the car. One of them was that Barry White, and then the other one was like a Total CD. And I was like, well, I'm going to listen to this Barry White. And I used to just put the CD in, and I would just keep repeating it over and over and over. Hmm. And eventually she probably got rid of the CD, I'm pretty sure. But at the age of 12, I'm pretty sure that was... that was one of the main songs I listened to.
Love it, love it. All right, my friend. Well, we've arrived at our destination. But before we get off of this time machine, there is a small declaration form. So it's yes or no. We're going to move pretty quickly here. Are you ready, Troy?
Absolutely.
Troy, have you chosen someone to pass on your skills to?
We have. I know me and Khalif have. Yes, I guess the answer would be yes.
Are you married?
Yes.
Do you have children?
No.
Do you believe in God?
Yes.
Do you have an inner circle of friends?
Yes.
Do you watch TV for more than 3 hours a day?
I don't. I'm going to say yes. All right. Unconsciously, I probably do. Yes.
What about screen time, the phone and the computer? Is it more than 8 or less than 8 hours a day?
I'm probably going to say more than 8. I mean, a mixture of my job and the phone, I guess. I do teeter between social media, I guess.
So, if you had to share with us, Troy, your own unique real statement, a statement that represents who you are, Troy Lee, what would you say that is?
Your only job is to make people better. It was a quote I recall from Tony Dungy. He wrote a book called Uncommon. And one of the things it says, your only job is to make your players better. But I think for me, your only job is to make the people around you better. And I think ultimately people, if you look it up, that's really the secret to life, you know, serving others and making others around you better. Because by making others around you better and providing a service to others, you in turn make yourself better. You know, all the riches that you will receive from making others better, it'll pay so much more in the long run than really any amount of money that you would be able to receive.
Love it. Can I add something?
Absolutely.
Make others better. Make others better, and remember to practice what you preach.
That's it. Practice what you're... that's exactly it.
Love it. Well, Troy, this has been a great pleasure. Again, before you leave, is there anything else you'd like to share with our amazing audience?
I would just like to, first and foremost, thank you for having me on here. Definitely a pleasure and a privilege to be on the show. I would say if they are looking for, you know, two individuals who understand sports and have a good time discussing it and debating it, definitely check out Debate Amongst Friends. Again, every Wednesday night we do release new content, as well as during the week we release different content when it comes up. Again, my production team here, we are releasing a movie early this year called Just a Little Sweeter. If you go on IMDb, I think you can start to see some of the information there. It's called Just a Little Sweeter, and we filmed that right here in North Carolina locally. But other than that, I think I am all set.
Love it. Troy Lee, thank you for being on What is Inspired by 12 Minute Convos with Angel Jones.
This segment has been brought to you by Amazel Enterprise.